Hello, welcome back to my notepad. We have returned to the circuit of the Americas. After the race at the weekend, I really want to do it in the dry. You might have seen the video which I did in the wet, and that was also pre-headset. Thank you, Amazon. One day delivery and didn't even cost a bit extra. Anyway, I'm back on F1 2016. I don't have F1 2017, 18 or 19, despite being a massive F1 fan. I just really like F1 2016, and why change the game if it's all pretty much the same, right? I know the new one's got GP2, Formula 2, whatever it's called, but yeah, I like F1 2016. I don't change things unless they're broken. Anyway, it's a 5-lap sprint. We have qualified in 14th. And Fernando's got a bit of a point to prove. Now we're extremely close to Sainz and Kvyat. I'm backing out of that slightly. Gotta be a bit cautious into turn one. Not to contact him on Vettel. Vettel's down in 10th. Anyway, we're in 11th. Yellow flags looks like in turn one, but someone behind us had a bit of an incident. Looking at the graphic. But this is a pretty good start. We've gained 3 places without doing anything. Anyway, assist-wise, I think the AI are on expert, so they're not on the highest. I've got no assists on, which makes car handling a real problem. And as you can see, I've got a Honda engine and that Ferrari is pulling away. Even last weekend was still better than what Vettel's doing here. Raikkonen's in 8th. What has happened to Ferrari? I mean, you could say a few things about perhaps their engine and the fuel flow meter, which has been discussed post-Circuit of the Americas. I don't think Max should have said what he said about them cheating. It brings it into a bit of disrepute, but I hope they haven't been. I always want to see Ferrari quite near the top. Anyway, Fernando's had a great exit out of turn 20. And he could try a bit of a diving move here, but he's a bit of a chicken and doesn't. And he's still holding on to 11th. Sainz doesn't look like he's got the pace in the Toro Rosso. I'm still trying to get my mind back to 2016. But yeah, Circuit of the Americas then, 2019. What did you think? He had a good race. I mean, probably start off with Bottas. He won, obviously. He just always seems to perform better when he doesn't need to. Start of the season, yeah, really good. You wouldn't probably say there's that much pressure at that point because everyone's starting from zero, for example. But as soon as it got a little bit under pressure, and he just starts to crack a little bit. But I'm still really happy that he won that race. Really pleased for him. Pole and a win. Can't get much better than that. I can't remember who got fastest lap now, was it? Was it Max Albon? Oh, anyway, let me know in the comments who got fastest lap. I can't remember. Who else got a really, really good race? Ricardo in the Renault. I mean, I don't think he was ever going to score any more points unless more of the leaders retired. So really strong from him. McLaren are there and thereabouts, and it's great to see. I mean, I'm sure Fernando's pleased. Norris was top of Q1, wasn't he, on lap times? So and he almost got Ricciardo at the end after McLaren put him on the soft tyre for the last laps. We're not really doing much here, are we? We're stuck in 11th, and if we're on lap 3, I think DRS is activated now. Maybe I can get a bit closer. We always have such a good run out of that turn, and Vettel is extremely slow. We've hit DRS as soon as we could, but now Vettel's going to start to ease away. See if I can get any. I'm going to maybe be a bit braver here. He's done it. Although Vettel's not giving up, but yes, he has now. Fernando of old against Sebastian Vettel there. Now we're going to try and get Mr. Perez. Raikkonen's still in 8th. Jeez. The race winner of the 2018 Grand Prix. Oh, I was really cheering for him in 2018. Ooh, and that's terrible driving by Fernando, and it's going to put him under some pressure by Vettel out of the last turn, but we've got DRS, and we probably might be able to get Perez here. Or not. Oh, we might be brave. Come on, be brave, Fernando. Good move. It's onto my favourite part of the track. Was Ron still in charge of McLaren in 2016? Any sort of role? Because if he was, he'll be certainly happy with this performance by Fernando. We haven't radioed in anything negative about the team. Ooh, I'm getting a bit too much on the throttle there. And we've got a Ferrari right behind us. He's obviously overtaken Perez as well. Are we in DRS zone of Raikkonen? We need it. We are. And also, we've got a very good drive out of there again. Or perhaps they've just got a really bad drive. But I don't think we can be brave this time. Let me know about F1 2019. I might get it. I don't normally buy games full price just out of principle, but I've watched that many videos of it now that probably I should. Is it really that much better than F1 2016? Because for me, the handling's... Well, I've never driven an F1 car, but it feels good. The cars are challenging to drive. The AI can be as competitive as you want it. Ridiculously competitive if you go on the top level and then you have no assist yourself. Almost lose the back end again. Final lap. Points mean prizes, so let's see what we can do. And obviously Kimi thinks the same. He's trying to go for Hulkenberg, but he's thought better of it. I thought he could have done that, really. It's a sign of Kimi in the later part of his career. He just had the speed sometimes, but didn't quite have the "I'm going to have him for that manoeuvre" attitude. Think of Belgium, for example. I can't remember what year it was, maybe 2017? Although the driving of Max Verstappen wasn't exactly cushy. I'm under more pressure from Vettel than actually... Oh, I've locked him at left front, but we're going to be on DRS soon. Let's see what Raikkonen gets out of here. If I get right in... Well done, Honda. But Raikkonen is thinking points being prized. Look at this, and... Oh my goodness, why did Raikkonen not go for that move? And in the end, we've got Raikkonen up into 8th position. Fernando's going to have a big smile on his face here, and we're all over Hulkenberg. Don't look at my gears then, that was also terrible. And we're going across the line into DRS, but it'll be too late. And 8th position for Fernando. The Spaniard with a fantastic 2016 USA Grand Prix. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in Brazil. And a happy
Davidson. Just so as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship.